Integration is a wonderful tool, but we want to get better at using it. And it's not such an easy thing. Compared to differentiation, with differentiation, there's about a dozen rules. You learn the rules. Life is good. You can differentiate anything. But with integration, it's a lot more subtle. And what it really boils down to in the end is there's a handful of things that we know how to integrate. And everything else, it's a matter of how to make it look like one of those things. If anything, you could summarize the art of integration in the following ways. Is it simple? Integrate it. If it's not, make it simpler. And that's it. That's how we approach pretty much everything. So if you learn nothing else, just remember, integration is about making sure things get simpler and simpler and simpler until we can integrate. But let's take a look at what we know and also where we're going so that we can understand what's happening as we enter into this next part of the course. All right, so where are we? What do we know? Well, there are 10 integrals that we can do. And these 10, we should just know by heart. Things like 1 over u, e to the u, cosine u, secant squared, tangent, u to the n, 1 over 1 plus u squared, a personal favorite of mine. Arctangent, beautiful. Sine, secant, tangent, and secant. And so now these are our basics. There's also some basic facts we should know. Things like integration is linear, so we can break it up over addition. And the substitution rule. The substitution rule, sometimes we just call it u sub, it allows us to say, hey, we can substitute a variable name. But the real goal of substitution is to simplify our expressions. As we said, simplifying is a very important tool and technique when it comes to integration. Here's a very special case. So if we're trying to integrate f of x, and we know what that is, then f of ax plus b, well, that's 1 over a, f of ax plus b. Okay, so that's just one simple example. So how do we approach integration problems? Well, more or less, we should think of it in the following ways. Is it 1 of the 10? Okay, then do it. Now, I include 1 of the 10 up to allowing things like throwing ax plus b in there. All right, so does it look like one of these? If it does, we're good, life is great. If not, is there some algebra or trig that we can do? In other words, can we simplify? How about, is there a u sub? Okay, if there is, do it. And then, okay, after you do algebra or trig or you do a u substitution, you start again. Is it 1 of my 10? And keep going. And sometimes it takes several rounds to actually make progress. Now that's what we know. Where are we going? Well, we're going to add some things. Now let's talk about first where we're not adding anything. You might say, cool, are we going to get up to like a dozen or 20 or 50? And the answer is no. 10. We're staying at 10. We're not adding, we're not subtracting. That's it. So you're like, what? Just these 10? Yes. Now, if you know about some of integration, you'll know that there's actually big, thick books, which are just books full of particular integrals, and say, oh, how do you integrate this expression? How do you integrate that expression? But really, all the books are just shortcutting things that we would do anyways. So if you're on a desert island, you can't, bring that book along. You say, look, that's fine. I don't need it. I just need to know the 10 along with the other things that we're going to talk about. All right, so that stays as it is. It's 1 of the 10. Now you might ask, okay, so we're going to add a lot of new boxes. We're going to add one new box in some sense. And that's a new box. We'll add it over here, and it's called by parts. Now, where does parts come from? If you think about u substitution, that came from the chain rule. There's another important rule in differentiation, and that's the product rule. So if the chain rule gave us u substitution, the product rule gives us parts. And so that's where we're going. And we'll talk about what that is in a minute. You're probably thinking, really? What else are we going to learn? Well, we're going to beef up our skills when it comes to algebra and trig. So for example, we'll talk about something called partial fractions. That's an algebra technique that allows us to pull apart rational functions. We're also going to spend some time talking about trig. In other words, how do we reduce expressions using trigonometric identities? And how do we solve particular integrals using trig functions? When it comes to U substitution, we're going to learn a nice technique called trig substitution. Now, a lot of people think, that sounds terrible. I've had nightmares about trig substitution. But I hope by the end you're like, oh, what a beautiful idea. Because trig substitution is really about how can we deal with square roots. And it's this really fun, beautiful idea. The thing that causes the square roots will be the thing that also helps us solve and get rid of the square roots. Fantastic. Now, I will say that there's sort of this interesting thing that happens with trig sub and doing trig integrals, which is you have the following sort of back and forth action. What happens sometimes is when we're doing an integral, we may start with a integral that uses trigonometry, and by appropriate substitution, we get to an integral that has algebra. In other words, things like polynomials and rational functions. On the other hand, trig substitution says, hey, I have something that has an algebraic expression, and what I'll do is by substitution, I'll make it into a trigonometric integral. So you have this sort of back and forth where you're saying, well, I'm having a hard time integrating this as a trigonometric thing, but I can shift it to an algebraic thing and life is good. Or I'm having a hard time doing this algebraic thing, but I can shift it to a trigonometric thing and life is good. This is sort of a beautiful idea in mathematics that shows up in several places where you can hop back and forth and say, let me translate a problem in this setting to a problem in a different setting, which has better tools and it's easier to solve. Now, in addition to what we have so far, there will be two other topics. One thing to know is there are things you just will never be able to integrate. But maybe we want to know the answer to a particular integral problem. So what if we want to know an answer to a definite integral? So we're integrating from a to b of some function. Well, we can use what's called numerical integration. Now, the idea of numerical integration is it goes back almost to Riemann sums, but we'll get a little bit more clever. And what we're trying to do is say, look, let's do approximation. Now, there's good reasons to understand numerical integration. First off, there are functions that you cannot find a nice antiderivative for. It's just known that there aren't. Not because we don't want to, not because we're not smart, it's just it doesn't exist. But there's another thing that might happen, which might be, look, I don't know what the function is. In other words, I'm out in the real world and I'm sampling data. And I know what's happening to this unknown function at many, many points, but I don't know what the actual function is. But I still want to know what happens to, you know, say the total. Well, that's a great tool for numerical integration because if you have sample data, that's perfect. You can use the data and figure out what's going on. And the other thing we're going to talk about is integrals that involve infinity. Sometimes these are called improper integrals, but you know, it's not so much that it's improper, it's just how do you deal with infinity? And there's two types. There's the type that blows up and the type that sort of blows to one direction or the other direction. In other words, you might have it as an asymptote internally, a vertical asymptote, or you might have it as a horizontal asymptote. And we'll learn how to deal with those as well. So that's it. That's where we're going. So in some sense, we're not throwing a lot more at you. What we're going to do is going to really strengthen our skills here. Get better at algebra and trig. Get better at substitution. Introduce a new idea. Go back to the idea of Riemann sums. Strengthen that idea. And you see that the way to deal with infinity is, spoiler alert, limits. Okay, all right, now we know. And so the big new idea is parts, and it's a beautiful thing. So that's where we're going, and it's not so bad. You can do it, and I hope to see you soon.